Okay, this is going to be a tutorial on setting up IVAs for KSP. I'm going to run through it fairly quickly. Hopefully, I won't miss anything important. I'm going to start with showing the mesh in the 3D application here. In this instance, I'm using 3ds Max. And then I'm going to cover a little bit on Unity tools setup. Part tool setup in Unity, which will give you the necessary windows and tabs to spawn the IVAs that you exported to KSP back into Unity so you can populate it with props and all the stuff. Also going to cover the transforms and layers that you need to spawn the kerbals, which will give you the little portrait cam in the lower right-hand corner of the screen while you're viewing your vessel from the outside. And then I'll cover the main part config file and the internal config file. And then hopefully everything will go correctly and we'll have a working command module with IVA in KSP. So start off here, we have view in 3ds Max. We got our I've as an example, I'm using the standard inline cockpit from Retro Future. I've got the parts separated out. This is the external view. This is what you'll see from the outside. This is just the frame. This is the windshield part. This really isn't necessary, but I like to do it just in case for future compatibility with stuff like transparent pods and whatever. In the middle here, we have the two collider meshes, the part for the windshield and the part for the main fuselage section. Over here is the IVA view. Basically, what it'll look like is something like this. So you've been looking at it from the inside. So you only see the inside of the mesh. That's why the outside are just open, because you'll never see that. And then here, over on the right here, this is basically a clone of the external window. And this is gonna be, this should be flipped inside out. So the polygons are facing inside because you'll be looking at it from the inside. And these are all aligned to the same pivot. So when I set them all together, when I export this, this is what it'll look like. I tend to export the inside and outsides in two separate parts. So I'm going to hide the inside first. Here's the outside. Let's export this. I like to use export selected because I build a lot of different pieces in the same max scene, and if I just export the whole file, I'm gonna have, I don't know, probably two dozen parts in the export, which is not really helpful in US KSP. So I'm gonna go in here. Well, let me do this outside. Let's see. IVA demo. Using Autodesk FBX, which is my preferred format. Here we've got some basic settings. For non-moving stuff, all you need is check the smoothing groups and nothing. Everything else should be left out. Units set to automatic. Up axis is Y up, which is the convention Unity uses, and KSP uses the same convention. Uncheck cameras, lights, other embedded media, because none of that stuff is going to be useful in KSP or Unity. So we're going to export, and then now we're going to export the inside, which looks something like this. Let's see, did I flip this? Yeah, okay. I'm just going to double check here, make sure I flip the inside correctly. maybe not. Flip, there we go. That's what I need to do. Okay, now we're ready to export. Anything you export in here is going to be static in the IVA. So if you want a moving, well, there isn't really any stock internal prop modules that'll let you do a controllable, mouse controllable or moving joystick. You can do it through RPM's raster prop monitor's variable animator, but that's a whole different topic, and that's quite a deep topic. I'm not gonna cover that today or touch on that today. Anyway, onwards, exporting the inside, export selected again. So let's call this IVA demoed interior. Same settings again, just the smoothing groups, nothing else since there is no animation. And now we import, just drag and drop these into Unity. And assets here, I'm going to make a new folder just to make organization easier for myself. Create folder, IVA demo, and drag and drop these in here. You can see they've come in. Came in with the materials, but I'm going to delete these because I already have materials set up. Now, if you're setting it up yourself, easy, you import your relevant textures into your assets or a subfolder, however you have it set up. And then just right click in here. You know, you can create your new material. I'll cover that in a second. Or use the imported material and change the shaders and assign the proper textures you need. Anyway, so when you first import, a few things you need to do. First, when there's no animation, set your animation type or rig to none and hit apply. And then this will be grayed out, which is what you want. And then in model, in the model tab over here in the inspector panel, set scale factor to 1, uncheck import materials, okay, and then same, do the same for the interior part, apply, none, and there we go. Now, all you have to do is just drag and drop it into your scene. Can uncheck show lighting, show real-time lighting in the scene. That way, sometimes it helps things to to make things a little easier to see. Okay, so we got our subparts. This is just an empty game object that contains all your actual meshes and colliders. I tend to add a CLL prefix that lets me know that this is going to be a collider and it's not going to be visible in game. So first thing I do is assign my collider, which is going to be, for the, in this instance, it's going to be a mesh collider. And they're going to be convex. For standard round parts, you could use the capsule collider. For the cockpit, you could also use capsule collider. They're more efficient in game. Actually, I'm just gonna do that here. I'm gonna delete this. Oops, I don't wanna delete that. I wanna keep that transform. I'm gonna remove these components. The mesh renderer component makes a mesh visible. The mesh filter component tells the game object which mesh that it should display. So you need both of these for any visible object in KSP. Now we're gonna, since this is gonna be just a mesh or a collision object, we're gonna remove those. I'm gonna add a capsule collider. Well, we're gonna have to move this up here. We're gonna rotate this 90 degrees. Now the radius down, make it a little bit bigger, just enough to cover the cockpit windshields here. That's about good. A little bit wider. Okay. Okay, that's set. Now we assign the materials. I have the materials created. Now, when you create your material, you want to make sure you're using the KSP shaders down here. Which reminds me, installing part tools. Let's see, you want part tools 0.23. When you open up the zip file, it's going to look like this. And inside part tools, there are these three folders. You want to drag and drop these three folders into the KSP assets folder right here. So what you'll end up with is assets, editor, library, and shaders. Shaders contains all your KSP shaders. Library, these are kind of, these are specific scripts that you assign to parts for export and stuff. Editor, these are things that add. These editor scripts basically creates this window, which is what you need to populate your IVA. So I'll come back to that in a second. Now coming back to the looks like I flipped the exterior windows by mistake. So, quick jump back into Max. Gotta hide these. Let's flip this back to the correct face. Export this again. Demo, yes. And now, since I'm replacing this export, all I have to do is just overwrite it in the KSP folder, which is I just have to do this. You're gonna get a warning. I want to override it with the newer version, and you should see it update. There we go. Now the facing is correct. This will be opaque from the outside, which is what you want. And the correct shader for this should be window opaque. Now for the external, that would be this shader. And to finish up the collider for the main fuselage section, we already added the mesh collider. Make sure it's convex. And then remove the mesh filter and mesh renderer components. Now we have a view of what this will more or less look like in game. Something useful to know for the windows or any glass material, these rim fall off settings are quite good for making adding a little bit more visual interest to your windows and the like. So what this does is it's kind of a tune shader kind of thing. So the more oblique the face, the tangent of your polygon is to the camera view, the more it's going to fill in with this color you select. So you set the opacity here, and the fall off sets the gradient from more oblique angle to a more direct angle here. I'm going to set this to red to make it more visible. So you can see the more sideways, the more parallel the polygon is to the direction of the camera, the more it shows the red color. So this is a nice and cheap way to fake reflective surfaces in KSP without using a reflective shader. So I'm going to set this back to some kind of sky blue color. Tweak this a little bit. There we go. So now you have a nice lit rim for your cockpit windows. So this is the exterior. Well, might as well cover this as well. We're going to add the, let's see, what do we need? Ladders and airlock. So, since they're both, I'm going to use capsule colliders for both the airlock and the ladder. I'm just going to duplicate this collider here a couple times and then rename them. This one will be airlock, and this one will be ladder. You can child the ladder to the airlock. That way it'll be easier to keep them in the same place. Reset the rotation. Basically, when a carbal spawns in the airlock, they're going to be facing the blue direction. Remember the pivot, it's going to be in the local space of the airlock trigger. So they're going to be facing the blue direction, and the up direction is going to be the green arrow, which is the Y axis. So move this down. So they're going to spawn roughly at this point. So they'll probably appear somewhere in this vicinity and then drop down, either drop down or catch the ladder. So hopefully this will have them catch the ladder here. We're going to set the ladder to be thinner than the airlock. That way the two collision meshes won't interfere with each other. We're going to set the ladder to a smaller radius. So for the ladder, they're going to climb up the Y direction and face the Z direction. And the entire height of the collider is going to be the length of the ladder. So the ladder we have here could be shorter. We'll make it 1.2. So while this is resting on the ground, they can grab this and climb up to the cockpit. And then the airlock, we're going to move that up a little bit higher. Okay, 1 and 0.4. The airlock you want big enough to contain a Kerbal, so a radius of 0.4 would be plenty. And you don't want it too much inside of your mesh. You just want it to touch slightly here. This way the Kerbal will have enough space to spawn. It could, because the Kerbal probably uses a capsule collider as well. So that it needs enough space to appear without colliding into your fuselage. Because if it does, then you might get the hatch obstructed message and probably tear your hair out. So we're going to set this ladder back to where it needs to. The ladder can intersect more because the Kerbal is going to appear on the negative Z side. So you want it this way to make them climb, to make them look like they're climbing up the surface instead of floating a bit off the side. So this should work out. Now the tags, you need to tag the airlock tag. And you want to tag the ladder as ladder, and you want to set both of these to a trigger. This way the Kerbal will still be able to walk through these colliders, but when you're inside of these colliders, you'll get the message either to grab the ladder or to board your command module. And to add tags, you go to up here in the upper right corner of your Unity interface. You have layers, edit layers, and the very top you have your tags. You just every time you add a new entry, the size will automatically increase to add another blank entry. So all you need, the element order doesn't matter for tags. You have your airlock tag and your ladder tag, which is what you need for the command modules. While we're in here, we need a couple of layers. Well, actually, yeah, a few layers here. Part triggers, that's for your airlock and ladder capsule colliders or box colliders, depending on what you use. And then internal space is for all the internal props. Anything on the internal space is going to be invisible to the Kerbal's portrait camera. And then the Kerbal's layer, which is number 16. Anything on the Kerbal's layer will be visible to the Kerbal portrait camera. So things like the interior frame, the back of your cockpit seat or whatever, those should be on the Kerbal's layer. Otherwise, it'll just appear as if they're in some black void. And the numbers, Kerbal's would be layer 16. Internal space should be layer 20, part triggers layer 21. All right, back to our scenes. We need to add the airlock and ladder layer to part triggers. Just double check ladder and part trigger layer, airlock and part trigger layer. Now we go to our root object. Actually, I'm going right. Important thing here is the orientation. The default orientation is, well, rather than explain it, I'll just show it to you. I'm going to child all of these to the main cockpit, that way I can move them all at once. The hierarchy order here isn't terribly important. So now the root object should be all zeroed out at scale 1. That's aligned to the world axis. And then you rotate your exterior 180 in the y direction, in the y axis, and then 90 in the x axis. So it's pointing up, and the z direction is the downward direction. So what this will look like in the vehicle assembly building is when you first drop this part into the scene, you'll be looking at the cockpit from the top down. This is pretty much what it'll look like when you spawn it in the vehicle assembly building. And then in space plane hangar, it's going to look like this. Because in the space plane hangar, the local Z of your mesh is going to be down. Well, no. Right. Yeah, the local Z is going to be down. So this is what it's going to look like in the space plane hangar. Now just remember this part and it'll be clear when we actually get the part into KSP. So we add our part tools. IVA demo external. Set our new folder, IVA demo. Now I'm writing this directly into the KSP game data folder to make things a little quicker. Select folder, check. Go right to ping or I tend to use Targa compressed. You can use ping or other formats, NBM. There are threads on the forum that cover the differences. I'm not going to deal with them here. So hit right. And then in your console, which down you bring up this window by clicking on the status bar here. And you should have these log messages telling you the MU file has been written, the two textures, relevant textures, have been written to the proper location. Now we will do the interior. So let's hide this briefly. Have our interior. Assign our textures. The internal frame is going to use the same material as the outside. The window has a slightly different material, uses opacity. Basically, it's a duplicate of the external window shader. External window material, but it's changed to KSP Alpha Translucent Specular. Now if I change this to the same as external, this will be what it looks like from the inside, and you won't be able to see through the windows. So you want to make sure you've got the Alpha Translucent shader. Again, the rim fall off and rim color settings are useful here. Now, to get this kind of dirtied up window effect, you want to do a alpha channel in your texture, window texture. Just let me go here. So diffuse, bring up this, make this preview a little bit larger. So the window section is here. This is the RGB channel, and this is what the windows look like from the outside. And then get a preview of the alpha. Here's the alpha channel. This determines the transparency of each pixel in this texture. White is completely opaque, so that's most of the cockpit. And then black is completely transparent, and then the shades of gray in between is various levels of opacity or transparency. So corresponding to what you see in the internal view here. So this is where you're seeing the frames are in all the white area, and then the windows are in the in this area. So let's set this back down. Now I'm going to add a window switch collider here that lets you double click on a particular window pane and give you a better view through it with a separate camera object instead of the default point of view camera that's spawned on the Kerbal. So I'm going to reset this, add a box collider, and I'm going to set this for the right window here. You can resize your colliders using, by holding down the shift key, you get these little green dots, and you can click and drag those to resize your collider box. So for this, we want a thin flat box that we can double click on while in IVA. Now the direction you want, Z is going to be the direction that the camera looks through, I believe. So Z is out, Y is up, R, X is the right side of your view. So we need to resize this collider box a little bit here. Just set this back to 1. So hopefully, so I normally don't do this, but this is one of the features in IVA. So hopefully once we get this exported, we'll have a camera that we can spawn here that lets you look through this particular window. Let's call this internal window left. We add our part tools. Now, of course, not to forget the layers. These should be set to kerbals. And this internal space of kerbals doesn't really matter because it's invisible. Let's reposition this a little bit. There we go. So once again, the kerbals layer is going to be visible to the little portrait cam in the lower right corner. So this is more or less which we'll see in the kerbal portrait cam, of course, minus the kerbal here. Now if you set this to internal space layer, then it will just be the kerbal and black space. So you want to make sure your the stuff you want to be visible in the portrait cam to be on the kerbals layer. Now this is the internal is a little bit simpler than the outside, so this is pretty much all you need to do. Let's see, might as well duplicate this and do a similar one on the right side. I'm going to set this to, there we go, and spin this around so the Z is pointing outside. So the camera is going to appear there, look to the right, and for here the camera is going to appear, going to be positioned there, look to the left. So we got our part tool, demo interior, target compressed, and where's our IVA demo? Stick it in the same folder, and right. Okay, that should be good for exports. Now we find our game data folder, IVA demo. Here's our files. Stuff we wrote out, and now we need to create a few config files. So let's do the IVA demo internal first because that's the easier one. Now it's gonna, you need to change the, it's just a text file, but you need to change the extension to CFG so KSP will know to parse it and load it into the game. The internal is going to start out pretty simple. At the top, all capital letters, your is going to be internal, and then curly bracket, and inside is going to be your, let's see, I believe module. All right, we missed one thing. We need to add a seat transform for the kerbal. So we're going to call this seat pilot. Reset. Put this in here. Now, thing to remember is the kerbal's pivot is at the bottom of their feet. So when the kerbal is spawned, the height, their height is going to be as if they're standing at this point. And when they're showing the sitting animation, they're going to be floating a little bit above this. So if you place your seat transform up here at the seat where you think it should be, the Kerbal is going to be somewhere up here. So you need to lower this down a bit below the seat. Although unless you're using some kind of transparent windshield, it doesn't really matter. And then for orientation, Z is the direction the Kerbal will face, and Y is the up direction for the Kerbal. So we need to rotate this 180 degrees in the Y. Now it's going to be in local space for the pivot, so that's going to be about right. Probably a little bit, yeah. So we need to write this out again so it has the transform for the seat. And while I'm back in Unity, need to cover the relative orientation of the inside and the outside. This is a pretty tricky part that took me a lot of trial and error to get correct the first few times around. So for the sake of simplicity, the best way I think to do this is to align all your external to the default orientation, which is this: Y up, Z down, and X to the right. And then your internal will be aligned this way. Now, if we look at the oops, gotta find the stock internals here. You can see how they're aligned. So here's a good one. The internal here, there's the local Z pivot pointed backwards. Well, this, let's see, better view of this is closer to what we're looking for here. So over here is the top of the Mark I cockpit. You see the Z axis is pointing towards the bottom of the cockpit. And then similarly here in the IVA part, Z axis is pointing backwards, and Y axis is pointing up. So to match this up with the external in Unity, you would need to rotate the internal by 180 degrees in the Y, and then 90 degrees in the X, so that this part will be pointing up and Y will be pointing in the negative Z. Right, so back in here to line this, if we want to line this up with the outside, we need to rotate this 90 degrees in the X and 180 degrees in the Y. So this is what KSB does when you switch. Well, I don't know if KSB does this, but RPM Transparent Pod does this in flight. If you have it active, it rotates, realigns the interior to the outside. So we need to set this back to 0, 0. So basically, for the default to line up, this is the relative orientations you need to have between the outside and the inside. So there's the outside. Its orientation is aligned to the world. And then the actual mesh, that's the local rotate at 90 and 180. That way you rotate the outside to match up with the stock orientation, then the inside you wouldn't have to rotate at all. So we export this again. We're back into our config setup here. Oops, still have it open. Let me bring up another config here so I know what I'm doing. Oops, that's the outside. Spaces. There we go. So for the inside, now the model node will work for the inside and the outside, and I tend to use that. So of course, internal, first thing is name. Now this is the name that KSP is going to refer to when it loads the internal textures and model and linking it to the command module. So let's call this demo IVA, or rather IVA demo internal, just like our export. Since this is all in the same folder, I'm going to use the model node to load this. IVA demo. IVA demo internal. Missed spelled model here. Okay, that should be good. And then we need our basic internal modules here. First one is internal seat. This is the transform that we added, which is this. This name is what you give the config. Seat transform name, seat pilot. Allow crew helmet. This is a true or false value. So if this is set to true, your Kerbal will have a helmet on. If it's set to false, your Kerbal will have no helmet while in IVA. And I have to add the camera switches. Need to refer to a stock internal. There we go. Here, we can copy and paste this. Change our collider names to what we put in, which is enter window left. Enter window left. Ah, yes, these window colliders need to be set to trigger internal space. Well, let's try it. Set them to trigger, and we need a second one. Right. And that should be all the basics we need. We close our internal node. Save. Now we come back to our part tools. We refresh our part tools panel, and then in spaces, there we go. We have our internal here, and we can click spawn and hide this. And now we'll import this back into Unity, and you can this at this point you can start populating the inside with props. But I'll cover that in a separate tutorial. But this is a quick way to check that your internal config is set up correctly. And while I'm here, the Part Tools tabs setup. This sets the data directory. Everything in here will be read, and any prop and internal config files will be loaded into these two tabs. So a internal file that we just created gets loaded into spaces, and then a prop config will get loaded in here. So again, quick way to check that your internal and prop configs are set up correctly is that they show up in here and you can spawn them. If you can't spawn them and get an error in your console, then it's either texture missing, could be a texture missing, could be your model node path is incorrect, or it may be something more serious that your model wasn't compiled correctly on export. Anyway, now we go and set up our external config, which I am going to use the original one. IVA demo, here we go. So let's call this IVA demo external. Be sure to change your part name, demo external. Change your model node path, IVA demo. IVA demo external. Now I'm only referencing the model. The textures are already in the same folder, so I can delete those parts. If you want clarification on how model node works, there is good stuff, good information on the forums here. The first place to look will be this thread, which Captain Kippard has so graciously put together for us. It's an updated version. It has links to pretty much everything you need to know to start making parts, IVA, EVA, externals, landing gears, landing legs, lights, any part that you could conceivably think of that you would want in KSP. All the information you need are here. Also, I have some references for creating custom parts for different mods. So, once again, new mod development, links compilation, that's the first place you want to look when you're thinking of creating parts or modding for KSP. All right, back to our config creation here. We got our model node set up. Got your attach node definition here. If in this instance, we're only going to have two stack nodes. Entry stuff, let's call this. This is going to be IVA demo. Can leave this description blank, attachment rules. It's gonna be able to stack, allowed surface stat, attach. I'm not going to cover most of this. The important part here is this highlighted section. Now this is how the external knows which internal it's linked to. So what we want to do here is point it to our internal, which is demo IVA internal. Capitalization is very important. Capital I is not the same as lowercase I, so remember this. That's one of the first places to check if something doesn't load in KSP. Capitalization and texture links. We'll leave all this stuff in here. We don't have the animation, so we're gonna have to delete that. Otherwise, we'll have spam of NREs, non-reference exceptions, in the log, which is not very good. So just to check once again, we got our part name. This should be unique. Otherwise, KSP gets mixed up loading the mesh on launch and stuff. Model node here, we point it to our MU file that we want to use. We don't need to type in the extension. Title, this is what shows up, what you see in the part icon in the part list. So once we start up KSP, we should have two identical externals. One of them will be called IVA demo and the other one will be called the regular part. And then the important stuff is the internal, curly brackets, name. That's the internal model that loads with this particular command module, command part. So we save this. And the moment of truth, just to double check our configs, start up KSP. The parts should, I'm going to clear the logs in case there's any issues. We can come back and have a clean log to sift through to see where things went wrong. So, moment of truth, load up KSP. Twiddle your thumb, get a cup of tea, make yourself a cup of coffee. And as I said, this video probably already ran pretty long, so just going to make sure everything works and then do a quick recap of all the steps, and then I'll do a separate. Okay, so far so good, game's loaded, go to our spaceship hangar. And looking good. We got our IVA demo. Looks good. Sign our crew. And launch. Okay, so far so good. We got our little portrait cam. Oops. Aha. So our orientation is incorrect. it appears. Now this is going to be tricky to figure out. Why is that? Okay, it's probably, well, let's check the outside first. We got our crew hatch, good. EVA, good. Where's our ladder? There's our ladder. Grab, climb. Okay, so it looks like we can move our ladder collider a little bit outside, but the hatch and ladders are working properly. That's good. Can board again. Now we just need to fix the orientation here. Should be correct. Let's see. Quick way to check if you got the wrong layer. No, it's the correct layer. Okay. This could be a little tricky. Make sure we get all the layers set up. Let's try this again. Jump back to Space Center. Reload our assets. Go back. No, still wrong. Huh. So let's rotate it. That's interesting. Okay, let me refer to the stuff I have that is working. So these are the working parts. Huh. That is right. Very strange. Space, internal space. That's odd. I think it's a config file issue since he still has his helmet on, which is strange. Let's check our config here. Model, correct. No. Part modules, no, it's. No, nothing. Seems fine there. module C transform. Huh, very strange. That is the correct orientation. And is that why? No, that's the correct orientation as well. Well, I will pause this video and then come back and once I get this sorted out.